Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Eguatu Angela, and today I'm going to be showing you some basic baking tools you will need as a beginner. If you are passionate about baking and you want to go into baking business, there are some tools you will need as a beginner. And today I'll be showing you some of the tools you will need to buy as a beginner. So don't go away, stay tuned to my channel because you will really need this. The first baking tool I'll be showing you is the scale. As a beginner, you need a measuring scale. This measuring scale, there are two types. This is a manual scale. We also have digital scale. So you can get yourself the one you can afford for now. Even this measuring scale also have a smaller one, the plastic one. If that is what you can afford, feel free to go get any measuring scale of your choice. And if you can't afford to buy a measuring scale for now, you can go for a measuring cup. Here we have 1 cup, 250 ml. We also have half cup, 125 ml. We have 1/3 cup, that is 83 ml. We have 1/4 cup, that is 62 ml. We also have 1/8 cup, that is 31 ml. So if you can't afford the measuring scale, you can go get yourself a measuring cup. But as time goes on, when you get orders, when you get profits, then you can go get yourself a measuring scale, either the digital or the manual scale. The next baking tool you will need as a beginner is a measuring spoon. You can see the spoons now. The measuring spoons. Here we have 1 tablespoon, 1/2 tablespoon, 1 teaspoon, 1/2 teaspoon, 1/4 teaspoon, and the rest. So go get yourself a measuring spoon. The next baking tool you will need is a sieve. You need a sieve. This sieve used to sieve out your flour while baking. The next baking tool you will need is a mixing bowl. You need this mixing bowl to mix your batter, your cakes, your cookies, what have you. As a beginner, you need a mixing bowl. So go get yourself a mixing bowl. Either you buy the aluminium bowl or the glass bowl. Let's move on to the next baking tool you will need. You will need a hand mixer. Need a hand mixer as a beginner. To make your work faster, you will need a hand mixer. I won't advise you as a beginner to go for a standing mixer. It's way too expensive. Though when you start using this hand mixer, as time goes on, when you get more orders, you get more profit, then you can go for a standing mixer. But for now, as a starter, go for this hand mixer. There are various brands of hand mixer, so you go get yourself the one that you can afford. So let me show you some of the tools in this hand mixer. We have the dough batter. We have the dough hook. We have the batter hook, and we have the whisker. Use it to whisk your egg. This one is to mix your batter, butter, sugar, flour, the rest. And this one is for mixing of dough, making donut, buns, egg roll, and the rice. You can use it to mix your dough. Then you just fix it. Fix any one you want to use, you just fix it here. And then you connect it to your sockets, and it starts working. So the next baking tool you will need as a baker is your baking pans. After mixing your butter, you will need your baking pan so that you pour your butter inside your baking pan before baking. So you will definitely need a baking pan as a beginner. So there are various sizes and shapes of baking pans. So you can just get the ones you can afford, and as time goes on, you get many other baking pans. And if you want to start a cupcake business, then this is for you. You can go get yourself a cupcake pan, something like this. Go get yourself a baking pan, and also get yourself a baking cupcake paper, baking cupcake paper that you insert into the baking pans. Now, there is another material you also need during baking. For instance, if you are baking in a round pan, you will need a baking paper. It is also known as a parchment paper. Hereby, before you pour in your batter, you will line your baking pan with a parchment paper, a baking paper, so that your cake will come out fine. Without getting bumps. So, what else? You need foil. Personally, I love using foil while baking. Do you know why? I use a charcoal oven to bake. And I don't want my cakes coming out with a smoky smell or getting bumps. So what I do is, I bring out the foil. After lying in my parchment paper, pouring in my batter, I use my foil to cover the surface of the pan and also the circumference of the pan, so that when my cake is coming out, it's coming out fresh without getting burnt. Now, when you are through with baking and the cakes are no longer hot, you use a cling film. A cling film is like a nylon. Use a cling film to wrap the cakes. Then preserve it wherever you want to preserve it, against decorating. So here is also something like this. Whisk your head. Then we also have scraper. You need a scraper as a beginner. The function of the scraper is while you're mixing your batter, you find out that some batter lying at the edges of the mixing bowl. So you use your scraper to scrape it down and continue mixing. What I use is a blender scraper. That is why it's like this. Blender scraper, that's what I've been using, and it's making my work fine. Also, when you want to apply, before pouring in your butter, you know you need to apply butter inside your baking pan, and also apply some little flour so that your cake will come out without any obstruction, because when you don't do this, discover that at the end of the day you will eat your cake yourself. When you don't when you don't put butter, and you don't put butter at the bottom of your baking pan, and you pour in your cake batter, at the end of the day, the cake will be stuck into the baking pan, and you have to eat it yourself by using spoon, and of course, it's a disaster. So you have to put in butter. So you use this to put some butter inside your baking pan, then apply little flour, dust it out, then apply your parchment paper. There is no way your cake will come out right unless you are not mindful of the time. So what else? Okay, you need a knife, yeah, to cut your eggs, to break your eggs. So I think that's all you need as a beginner. That's all you need as the beginner. Want to start a baking business? Okay, yeah. You also need the most important thing. You need an oven. It's also very important. You need an oven to bake your cake. But if as a beginner you don't have the money, you can't afford an oven for now, then you can go with pot and stove. You can go with pot and stove, but I won't advise you to use stones, to line your pot with stones or sand, because many people has been complaining about sand inside cakes, which I'm even surprised, because if you want to use pot and stove, you either use a flat stainless plate inside your pot, and once it is very hot, then you can put your pan filled with butter inside the pot, cover the pot, and that is your oven. But if you can afford an oven, you can get yourself a charcoal oven or a gas oven. And if you can afford a generator, or you are in an area where electricity is available 24/7, then you can go get yourself an electric oven. So we've come to the end of our lecture today. If there is any baking tools I forgot to mention, please show me and tell me at the comment section. I would love to read all your comments concerning this video. If you like it, if you learn one or two things in this video, please give this video a thumbs up, and always switch on your notification bells, and please subscribe to my channel to help my channel grow. Till then, bye-bye.